Joining me now is Corazon Mining Managing Director Brett Smith to discuss the expansion of the company's tenure in Manitoba. Brett, thanks for joining us.
Hi, Jonathan. Thank you.
Now, you've expanded your landholding in Manitoba. Can you talk me through the terms of the acquisitions and what strategic advantages they now bring to you?
Okay, yeah. So we've acquired some, or in the process of acquiring some new mineral claims. Strategically, they're some distance from Lynn Lake, about 65 kilometres from Lynn Lake are the main deposits. The strategic advantage is that we believe they're high value assets, and at some stage, I guess historically, looking at them historically, they've always been treated as potential satellite deposits to a mining centre, and historically that mining centre has been Lynn Lake, so we're not reinventing the wheel here. It has been talked about in the past.
And one of those key assets is MacBride, and they've had really good historic results, which I'm guessing is what attracted you to it.
Yeah, MacBride discovered, I think, in the 1950s, and drill campaign wise over the years up until the 1990s. It's very good grade from surface, between 8 and 10% zinc plus copper, and a little bit of gold as well from surface. It's drilled over about a 400 meter strike within a recently defined geophysical anomaly of about 1800 meters. So there's some upside there, but it's been well drilled. The Canadians have Canadian companies in the past have released historical resources on MacBride. We don't consider it resource status as far as JORC goes. 6Ks from that is Wellmet. Wellmet hasn't been available to anyone for the last 30 years, so we grab that. And it's pretty similar to MacBride, but a lot higher copper and gold.
And how do these acquisitions play into the potential restart of mining operations at Lynn Lake?
Well, quite obviously, 8 to 10% zinc is a lot more valuable than 1% nickel. So if we're looking at a restart of the mining operation at Lynn Lake as a nickel sulfide project, we really need to consider, as a startup high-value feed, is this zinc-copper material worth considering? And we've got about 7 deposits of our own in the Lynn Lake tenure right near the nickel mining centre, so we'll be incorporating those as well.
And I want to touch on something Terry Streeter said in the announcement this morning. He said, we don't need more tonnes. This VMS concept is about value. Can you give us an elaboration on what that is all about?
Yeah, well, what we're trying to do at Lynn Lake is reduce the operating costs. So get a low operating cost, make it a robust, long-lived nickel sulfide project, so the ups and downs of nickel price don't affect it. In doing that, you reduce your cutoff grades, you incorporate a lot more, let's call it ore, and you have a lower feed grade into your mill. What is essential for a project restart is have high value up front. So if we can identify high value nickel, we try to move that up front in the mining process. And also it's the same with this zinc and copper. If we can exploit these zinc copper deposits and they give us a better return, why not do it? The processing techniques are very similar. In fact, it's the processing techniques for zinc and copper are a lot more simple. You get better recoveries and it's better value.
So, looking overall, I mean, what role do you envision Lynn Lake playing as a regional polymetallic processing hub?
Definitely, if we're looking to process zinc copper, there's a lot more zinc copper deposits in that region that could fall into the transport envelope. So that's something of interest. We are very much focused on the nickel. Nickel, copper, and zinc are critical metals in North America. Now, the big issue with nickel is that with a high percentage of nickel products coming from Indonesia, the Indonesian nickel enterprise has about 74%, 75% Chinese investment, so Chinese ownership. So that's a big issue in North America. It means that battery makers, automakers don't comply with what's required for tax benefits in the US. Any local metal is very valuable.
So Brett, you've had your nose to the grindstone over the last few months and plenty of work being done. Talk us through what we can expect to see from the company over the coming weeks and months.
Yeah, there is a lot happening behind the scenes, Jonathan, especially with respect to the mining studies and met work. That's not very newsworthy, but it's continuous. We expect that work to all come to an end in around September. So if we can release any information about that, we will, but a lot of it's not really impactful to the market. And next really exciting things, and we are valued as an exploration company, so drilling's important. The next thing we've got on the schedule here is putting some holes into Mount Gilmore, where we've generated a target for a joint porphyry copper deposit. Never been drilled, but we shrunk the Mount Gilmore geochemical target from about 20 k's copper target, copper anomaly, sorry, down to about 2 km with the assistance of the University of Tasmania. So we're pretty excited about this.
Brett, I look forward to seeing how all that unfolds, and thanks for your time today.
Thanks, mate. Good to talk to you.